A lot of people outside Germany have been asking me how worried I am that a far-right populist party will enter the German parliament in this building right behind me for the first time since the Second World War. Does it mean that Germany could become racist again, anti-Semitic, nationalist? Does it even mean that German democracy becomes unstable again as it was during the Weimar Republic? The party in question is called the Alternative for Germany. It's only 4 years old and it's already had some big ups and downs, but it really took off starting in the fall of 2015 when the refugee crisis hit. Since then, the party's become increasingly and explicitly anti-immigrant. Depending on which member of the party you listen to, their rhetoric ranges from arch-conservative but still mainstream to blatantly xenophobic. And some members of the party have even played with language that was popular during the Nazi era. Now, in Germany, with its past, that is more shocking than it would be in other countries. Since the Second World War, there have already been several attempts by far-right parties to get into parliament, and they've all failed. The Alternative for Germany appears to be different. It's going to get more than 10% of the German vote, and so it'll get into parliament, and that will be historic. But it's not something to worry about, and here's why. First, the Alternative for Germany is most popular in East Germany, where it's actually become a rival to another party, the Left Party, which descends from the Communist Party of East Germany. And both of those are protest parties that are attracting frustrated Easterners who want to vent their anger about the way reunification has worked out for them. In Western Germany, the alternative is much, much weaker. Second, if you look at other European countries, they all have parties that are like the Alternative for Germany, or even worse. And those parties actually get often a higher share of the vote. So the fact that in Germany it gets relatively little of the vote actually is important. It suggests that Germany is still inoculated by its Nazi past against real far-right extremism. And third, the fact that all the other parties have ruled out a coalition with the Alternative for Germany, it means that it won't get anywhere near power. On balance, this means that yes, some frustrated and angry Germans and some racist and anti-Semitic ones have finally found a party that they are comfortable voting for. But remember that those Germans were there all along. The Alternative for Germany has merely made them visible. And by making these views visible, it exposes their ugliness to all the other Germans. Remember that 9 out of 10 Germans are voting against the Alternative. So overall, the fact that the Alternative is now in the parliament probably only means that Germany has at long last become a normal country. German democracy is stable, most Germans are tolerant, and I think the country can absorb the Alternative for Germany. I'm not worried.